pretty place for her.
31-year-old Melinda James, a mother of three, is fearful for her life after she was allegedly threatened by her cousin, whom she claims made a video recording and told family members that she would kill her. A traumatized James subsequently went to the Cove and John police station to report the matter. However, she was told by the officer on duty that the police cannot arrest the cousin making the threats, simply because the woman referred to her exclusively by her alias, Fine Things, rather than her given name. Headline News spoke to James, who explained what caused the grievance.
It had its place to it. My mom asked me to assist my cousin this place to it. But I explained to my mom, I do not want family to live around me. So I end up now, you know how to know that we's family, go and get through this place. I explained to her that I would have to be the one to say that I want the place to rent, and the rent receipt would be in my name. She said, okay, she agreed to everything. Now I end up get through the place, pay the money now, and get through the place for her. Her husband was to meet with me for me and him to go, that he can stand up for she, you understand, to get through the place. He didn't get to meet with me. I end up now take my money and pay to get through the house for her. And she end up moving the house the other week. The next week now, the owner them for the house come to check on the place to see how I am coping in the house, because I lately move in the house. And I told her, if they come and they ain't see me, tell them you and me's cousin, and I gone out and you just come to assist me. She told them the opposite story, that I am living next door and she's the one renting the place. Unfortunate, the owner them for the house know her. The owner teach our kids in school. And she said that she don't want her in the house. She didn't rent the house to her. And I have to be the one to get her out of the house because she rent the house to me. She gave her 1 week to move out. I beg for 1 month, which she say, okay, fine, give her 1 month.
According to James, her cousin only spent a week in the house and was fully refunded. Nonetheless, verbal threats were still made against James.
Last week, I had a cousin that died. I went on a funeral to Burbies. And I saw her. I tried my best to avoid her. And one of her sisters called my mother and told my mother that how see that she gonna burn me with acid. And if she burn me, that I gonna get blind and I ain't gonna see back. So that is when now I start to like say, I can't sit and I can't sleep on this one. I need to make a report and let her name get out there and see like what help I could get now. You understand? Because I can't get burned from acid. I have 3 children that I have to live for. She make a video last week, Sunday, concerning that she want to chop me in my head and on my mouth. She want to kill me and then kill herself. For what reason? I do not know.
Headline News viewed the videos made by James' cousin. In the video, threats were made to the individual, which only identified the person by their alias, Fine Things, and first name Melissa.
So presently, there is no report could make at no police station because she didn't call me by my first name. That's what they say. And they say that I shouldn't put the video out because she didn't call me by my first name.
James intends to pursue the case further because she's concerned that if the authorities do not intervene, she will die or be gravely hurt. For Channel 2 Headline News, Esther Sobers.